So the signs and symptoms of an opioid overdose are, one, you can't get the person to respond to a pain response. So you take your knuckles and you rub them firmly on their sternum. If they do not respond to that, that's a key indicator that they've overdosed. Another indicator would be blue or palish lips and nails. Another indicator would be their breathing. Is it really shallow? Is it raspy? Is it paused? So there's no breath sound and then a big gasp. Those are all indicators that somebody has overdosed. So the first thing you want to do when you have determined that a person is not responding to that pain response is you want to call 911. Immediately do that. Act fast, go get your phone, call right away. The next step you're going to take is you're going to get your naloxone. When you get your naloxone, then the next thing you're going to do is immediately give 2 rescue breaths. You're going to then administer the naloxone. It doesn't matter if you have the intramuscular naloxone or the nasal naloxone or the auto-injector. They are all the same. It's just a different way of administering it, but it all works equally well. Then the next thing you do is continue to give rescue breaths until help arrives or 2 minutes have gone by. If help has not arrived, if your first responders have not arrived and 2 minutes have gone by, you're going to give a second dose. So you can go to your prescriber's office and get it from your doctor. You can go to pharmacies and walk in and speak to your pharmacist, and your pharmacist can write you a script and give it to you on the spot. If your pharmacist isn't carrying it, it's a great opportunity for you to get engaged in creating the solutions that we need to see across our country and ask your pharmacy to please start carrying it. And then you can contact the Steve Rumler Hope Foundation and come to us. If you come to the Steve Rumler Hope Foundation, we will train you on how to recognize, administer, and what you're likely to experience once you save your loved one's life. And when you come to our trainings, you'll leave with a kit. Typically speaking, the shelf life on all naloxone, whichever administering device it is 2 years. Other than that, if you're prescribed it, you will see the expiration date on your prescription, on your bottle, on the vial, on the device itself. If you look at each individual dose of naloxone, the expiration date is actually on there as well. Naloxone is light sensitive, which is why we give out the kits in these bags so that they're protected from the light. Naloxone is also cold and heat sensitive, so you want to keep it relatively within room temperature. One of the things to note, though, is if you have naloxone and it's been in your car, we live in Minnesota, so our temperatures are fairly extreme, very hot and very cold. If your naloxone has been left in a car and it's 10 below zero, and that is what you have, you still want to use it. If the naloxone has reached its expiration date, you still want to use it. If that's all you have, then use it. Whether it's that you have relapsed with the disease of addiction, or you've been prescribed high doses of opioids, or frankly, you're in an acute situation like you've had dental surgery and your dentist has prescribed you opioids. All of those times you want to get naloxone, then you really want to sit down with your family members and explain to them, I have received the antidote. Should I overdose on an opioid? These are the steps that you take.